What's up? This is Josh from Josh Kid Films. Thanks for tuning in. Today I want to talk about using Canon FD lenses on the Pocket 4K. There's a few different reasons why we chose to use Canon FD lenses pretty much exclusively on our Pocket 4Ks. The first reason, that's probably the biggest reason for a lot of people, is the price. They're very, very affordable and they cost much less than traditional modern lenses. But the quality that you get is on par with modern lenses. So it's really a great value if you're looking for something cheap that will get the job done at high quality. One of the other reasons we like to use Canon FD is because of the look. There's a specific look that vintage lenses have, especially Canon FD, that modern lenses just can't reproduce. The Canon FD lenses are slightly softer than modern lenses, but not in a way where you'd think, oh, that looks out of focus, or that just doesn't look sharp. They're still very sharp and detailed, but on a digital lens, the edges are so crispy and so sharp that it almost looks artificial. There's a smoothness to the edge on a vintage lens and a Canon FD lens. It's very appealing to the eye. To me, these lenses just produce a more filmic look. And that might not be right for every project you're working on, but for the majority of work that I do, that's the right fit. Another thing I really like about the look is the color and the color rendition. I just get a really rich and warm and beautiful color out of these lenses that I haven't gotten with modern lenses. I feel like when I'm grading these in DaVinci Resolve, it's like they just soak up the colors and I can take them pretty much anywhere I want, but it never looks harsh and it never looks unnatural. There's a lot of ways to get a filmic look out of your Pocket 4K, but I feel like when I'm shooting Canon FD lenses, they just get me there a lot faster without having to do so much in front of the lens to try to create that look. A third reason that I really like shooting the Canon FD is the way that they're built. These old vintage lenses, they're all manual, so they have smooth focus rings and they have manual aperture control on the lens. That makes it really easy to adjust these lenses without having to rely on your camera body for everything. I just wanted to show you some of the lenses I've chosen to be in my Canon FD kit and hopefully steer you in the right direction if you're looking into vintage lenses and looking at Canon FD and you're unsure which ones you should buy. Check it out. This is the Canon 20-35L 3.5. This is a zoom lens with a very useful focal length, and when it's paired with a Metabone speed booster, the speed is more than acceptable. This lens has a very rich look like most of the Canon FD-L lenses do. It's a little bit more expensive for a Canon FD lens, but it's still very reasonable when you compare it to a modern lens. The next lens that I have in my kit is a Canon FD 24mm 2.8. Canon made most of their primes in three versions that differ by speed. The 24 has a specific L version that's very expensive and very rare that goes to 1.4, but for the most part, it's F2, F2.8, and F3.5. I have the 2.8 version. This is a great wide lens that has beautiful colors, great sharpness, and decent speed at 2.8. You can typically find these for around $100 if you look on eBay. The next lens that I have is the 28 F2. This is a really, really fun lens to shoot on. It's one of my favorites. It's a great focal length, right between 24 and 35. So it's still got some wideness to it, but it's a little bit closer than the 24, and it looks really nice for portraits. At F2, it's pretty fast. It's only slightly soft at F2 and incredibly sharp at F2.8. The next lens that I have in my kit is the 51-4. This is like a bread and butter lens for Canon. They made a lot of these. It's very fast, it's very beautiful. It achieves shallow depth of field very well. It's still relatively sharp at 1.4, although it's a little dreamy. I typically stop down to about F2 just to sharpen it up a little bit. This is a must for your lens bag. The next lens that I have is the 85-1.8. This is a beautiful portrait prime. It's fast, it achieved a really nice shallow depth of field, and it's your classic 85 with the richness and the uniqueness of a Canon FD lens. The next lens I have in my bag is the 135-2.8. This is a really nice telephoto lens. It's small, so it's really portable. It has an integrated lens hood. It's very sharp at 2.8. and it's just a really nice focal length for shooting portraits. I love this lens, it's one of my favorites. It's also really affordable, so you can get a really nice look without having to spend all the money for the 135 F2. I have a few zoom lenses that are very useful too. This is the 50-135 3.5. This is a really nice lens. It's very sharp at 3.5, very usable. The focal range is really nice. It's great for shooting B-roll where you still have 50, so you can get a little bit of wideness, but you can also get very close with 135. It's a really nice, useful lens. This is one of my favorite lenses. This is a 70-210 f/4. This is a super useful lens and they're super affordable. You can usually find them in the $30-$50 range in mint condition. They have a macro mode at 70 that's really useful and produces great macro shots. The range is really nice. It's small, so it's portable, and you can use it on a monopod with minimal shake. This is one of my favorite lenses in my kit. This is the big guy. This is the 50-300L. This is a beast of a lens. It's all metal. It's built really, really well. It's really robust. This is what I call my movie lens because I typically hook it up to the full rig with the matte box and the lens support and the follow focus. It's got a really usable range at 50-300. The shallow depth of field and the compression at 200-300 is just absolutely gorgeous, and it just has a look to it. It's very filmic and very movie-like. What's really cool about this lens is if you use it with a dummy adapter and not a focal reducing speed booster, then the range goes all the way to 540, so it's really long when you want it to be, or you can use it in the 50-300 type range with the speed booster, which is really close to 50-300. I think it's like 65-320 or something like that. So it's a very, very versatile and useful lens. These are the lenses I choose to shoot with pretty much every day for most projects that I do. I love their filmic look. I don't have to work very hard to get it. They're super friendly in the color grade. I can't say enough good things about them. We typically use them with the Metabone Speed Booster Ultra 0.71. This allows us to use the wide lenses and they still stay pretty wide and useful. And it also gives us extra light for some of the slower lenses. There's a lot of tests and demos of these lenses on my YouTube, so check them out. You'll get a nice idea of the look and the feel of these lenses and the vibe that you should expect. We hope you will turn on notifications and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any more lens tests or future videos. We hope that you have a great night.